A child with disabilities needs both parents equally. That is why it is very important for the family to be explained how it can be cared for, to be explained in detail what the diagnosis includes, to be able to respond properly to the child's needs. Parents must be the most involved in the recovery and treatment process. Some parents cannot come to terms with this idea. They go into denial. They say that there is nothing wrong with their child or that they are not as affected as they have been told. They delude themselves. They look for explanations. They go to every doctor hoping to find a way to heal their child. Many of them feel guilty and responsible for what is happening. If the family consists of several children, the parents focus their entire activity on the one with disabilities, neglecting the others. When the child is enrolled in an institution, the parents have very high expectations from the staff and from the child. Therefore, there must be a mutual collaboration between the parent and the teaching staff. Social acceptance begins with acceptance of the child in the family. There the first relationship takes place, which must be natural, without extreme exaggerations, slowness, or abrupt of non-acceptance. The child needs the same sentimental and social relationships as those around him, being and carefully followed the first sign. When he listens, when he looks, how he responds to the surrounding and stimuli. If he recognizes those around him and if he learns certain things about them and about everything that surrounds him. Goodman published a very useful analysis regarding the connection between various types of threat-based early education and various vulnerabilities to anxiety and depression. The lack of any type of parental care, as they emerges from studies conducted on institutionalized children in Romania, highlights how harmful these experiences are. The absence of the other. We must distinguish between the problems related to the absence of the other. That is, to distinguish the person when the parent does not play the role of calming agent from the threatening ones in which the parent or others can cause suffering that leads to fear of an abandonment. Parental unavailability. These people have probably experienced parental separation and abandonment. Sometimes this happens as a result of parent's illness, his death, or divorce. Many parents have observed that when they give their children more attention, get involved in their games, minor emotion and behavior problems are solved. Parental inaccessibility. Parents might be physically present but not able to provide sufficient attention or emotional support. They may not be able to help their own children when it comes to their feelings and make them feel safe with them. Very understanding mothers try to observe their children's experiences right through the child's eyes and look for explanations from his perspective. The one-sided mother isn't eager to take care of their own child, but has preconceived ideas about the child's needs and a one-dimensional image. Researchers believe that such an attitude can lead to inappropriate care. Parents need affection. These people use their own children to increase their own inner need to be loved or for them to give them meaning in life. And addicted parent may try to turn their own child into a caregiver by always using humiliation or guilt. Anxious parents. Some parents are extremely anxious about their own safety, but also about the safety of their children. Instead of being a source of peace and calm for the child, they are rather the ones who shake the children. Depressed parents. they can have a harmful impact on the development of their own children. If the mother is not able to interact with her own child in such a way as to convey to the child a state of relaxation and affection, this leads to problems in the development of certain positive affective systems of the child and to delays in affective development. Parental criticism and control. Parents who are excessively self-critical and authoritarian and or excessively humiliating in their efforts to force their own children to obey often form people who are highly sensitive to humiliation and criticism from the other side. There is much work showing that intense emotions are favored vulnerability factors for a range of dysfunctions, including depression. Parental styles. Moraru identifies the following parental styles. The permissive style presents a low level of parental control. Few rules of conduct and few responsibilities are imposed on the child. Parents grant independence and freedom to the child, show high love but low limits, confuse the child's aggressiveness with his affirmation. Parents do not value themselves enough. It is an ineffective parenting style in the long run. Authoritarian style shows a high level of parental control. Parents establish limits, principles, and rules of moral conduct and transmit values such as work, authority, discipline, order, love, respect, etc. Democratic style or balanced is based on the democratic concept of equality and trust. Parents and children are equal in terms of the need of dignity and valuing responsibility and decision making. Parents encourage, explain, communicate, collaborate with the child in a gentle, empathetic way. Careless or rejection style. Lack of communication, control, and emotional involvement in the child's life. Parents show how love and low limits. The child does not benefit from food, shelter, clothing, medical care. The parent does not offer the child emotional support or attention. Child neglect is a phenomenon specific to immature, mentally ill, dependent, aggressive, and unstable parents. Authoritarian and abusive parenting style shows high limits and low love. Obedience and respect at any cost are valid. Parents do not encourage their children to solve problems, rules and household chores are not negotiated. Discipline is confused with punishment, physical in most cases. It develops anxious relationship, fear, avoidance, unhappiness, pain. The feeling of own value and self-esteem suffers greatly. The child feels unworthy and maladjusted, fails to relate adequately to the physical and social environment. From other point of view, Sorlea and Florea highlight another typology of parental styles as follows. The protective parent, the one who offers the child security, a protective environment, sacrifices himself for him, takes into account, consider only the positive aspects of the child, not the negative ones. However, the parent only satisfies the child's needs and easily gives in to his request.